Hello, my name is Eric Roeder, and I work in business development for Codelation. My team of elite nerds is dedicated to helping turn big ideas into first customers. Building apps and helping develop new businesses allows me to meet amazing people. These people are doing amazing things in our tech community and my actual community of Fargo, North Dakota. I wanted to start a platform to help business leaders and other great people in our community tell their story. Connecting with amazing people is my job. Welcome to my office. We're changing the entire internet, one positive person at a time. My guest this week is Brittney Hogan of ShareHouse. She took a real life struggle for herself and she turned it into a career helping others with that struggle. And we're going to chat a little bit about it this week. Welcome, 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 internet. I'm here with Brittney Hogan of ShareHouse now. And yes. What's with those? Like, that's fun.
I got my ears out.
Do I get ears?
Well, I did bring some extra ears. I was hoping you wanted to.
Always. Okay, so this is our first episode without Maddie. Is the thing still in frame? Marketing assistant Suman. My brain's still up there. Good, good. So yeah, let's start. We'll just tell us a little bit about yourself.
About me?
Yes.
Well, Brittney Hogan. Yep. I am the new foundation director for ShareHouse. Mm-hmm. I've been in the Fargo area now doing some fundraising for about 2 years. Okay. And just been loving life here.
Yeah, no, and you're new to ShareHouse, so I'm excited to learn about it. Can you tell us a little bit about ShareHouse and what it is and who they help?
Yes. So ShareHouse has been helping the Fargo, kind of the whole North Dakota community for over 45 years. Mm-hmm. Treatment, facility, addiction, but becoming a lot more than that.
Sure.
We do the dual diagnostic approach to recovery, knowing mm-hmm. that a lot of times there's the mental health aspect to
sure.
addiction. And
yeah.
We have just a lot of services and programs I've been learning about, and it's just been a great organization to get to be a part of.
Oh, and again, it's been a long time since I've seen you,
mm-hmm.
and that's stupid. And I actually, I made a little business chart this week, kind of going over like my friendship participation from in my lifetime. And so we're born in the 80s, first day of school, and we're at Bill and Ted level. And I dropped 2020 below Squidward.
Ooh.
And so that's tricky, but we're on our way back up.
I see that.
We're on an upward slide, and I'm really excited about it. And yeah, can you tell us a little bit, because like I said, last time I saw you, we were in a different role.
Mm-hmm.
Let's talk about this new role.
Yes. So I love fundraising.
Right.
So I get to still be part of fundraising. However, being part of the ShareHouse Foundation, it's been a little bit, I don't want to say stagnant for a couple years, but mm-hmm. we haven't had a director for a few years. So
okay.
I'm get a new opportunity to grow the foundation.
Oh, wow.
We're in a really exciting place with healthcare and behavioral health right now, that it's kind of an exciting opportunity to get to connect community people with the great things that ShareHouse is doing.
No, and you can tell you're genuinely excited about this role. And
mm-hmm.
we chatted a little bit about that. And that's so important in any nonprofit, is you just have passion about who you're trying to help and the foundation. And that's...
Yeah.
Ah.
I know. I feel like I should just tell the story again because... It was that moment where you just knew I made the right choice
right.
coming here.
Mm-hmm.
I was in the elevator and one of the clients had hopped on with me and we were just complaining about the very slow elevator
right,
at ShareHouse.
Right. North
Sorry.
Dakota chat. Yeah.
But yeah, doing our thing and we said our goodbyes. And as soon as I got in my car, I just lost it. Yeah. I was bawling tears because my dad has actually been in and out of prison my entire life.
Sure.
So I've experienced that world, and that guy reminded me, he had just everything about him was like my dad.
Oh,
and it was that moment where it was the best crying ever because I was where I was supposed to be. I get to again connect the community with ShareHouse
right.
and grow, and it was just that great feeling.
So. Oh, God. Yeah. And I. Glad we retold that one. So, I don't know. My tiara is being a little goofy. They have hearts on it. There's Giving Hearts Day coming. Mm-hmm. Let's talk about what that is for people who don't know.
Yes. So for this year, for Giving Hearts Day, because that's when I got my ears out. Yeah. When I was moving to Fargo, I did Giving Hearts Day in Minot also, and I found my ears. And it was like one of those, like, it was meant to be my ears moment. But but yes, so Giving Hearts Day this year, we actually opened a walk-in clinic last year when everything else was shutting down.
Oh, wow.
We knew that that moment when I'm able to convince you that it is time to go to recovery, but your appointment's not till next week, can be life or death for some people.
Right.
That we have now a walk-in clinic Monday through Friday, 8 to 5. Come on, Eric, let's go start this journey. Mm-hmm. We're here for you. And that's what everything this year for Giving Hearts Day is.
Sure.
So $100 equals one assessment for our new walk-in clinic. Mm-hmm. So how great of a thought is that? Donate $100 and you get to help somebody start their journey towards recovery.
Oh, I just like that. And like I said, this is fun. Are you guys doing any events or is it just online fundraising or what do you got?
Yeah, just going to see me on social media with my ears a lot. And that's where it's really great with the foundation is I get to be out there and just kind of a cheerleader for ShareHouse and just spreading all the great work that they've been doing for so many years.
Right. And so, yeah, we'll put this on our social media. So that's a way to help.
Yep.
What else can we do to help?
Give on Giving Hearts Day.
Yeah. Easy enough.
My
ears are losing out of control.
Yeah. Any way that you can spread the word about ShareHouse and Giving Hearts Day is doing a lot of cool sweepstakes this year, and I think you can win a truck. So
I saw an email about a truck.
Yeah.
So that would be an interesting, a little more incentive than normal. Mm-hmm. And I've always been just a fan of everyone kind of coming together and working for that. And so, yeah, let's share things, share with ShareHouse, donate, and you know, help in any way we can. Can't come down here and not get our nerd question. It's like dreadful cold.
Yes.
Like, I know where I live, and I know it's January, but it's not that a negative 30 wind ever is. I'm not okay with that ever. So what are you binge watching as we get into binge watching hibernation season?
Binge watching hibernation season never ends for me.
Fair enough.
All summer long.
Yeah.
But I just jumped on the Ozark bandwagon.
Oh, yeah.
I tried to start it like three different times. Just finished season one. So.
Okay.
Yep.
Oh, I like that. Me and Suman are obviously super skilled camera guy who's doing this for the second time. We watched Avatar and then Legend of Korra. Oh man, if you guys haven't watched that, both like I was crying. It was so good.
Really?
It's amazing. So yeah, that's my nerdy thing. So yeah, nerd questions mean we should wrap things up. Brittney, do you have anything else?
No. Again, Giving Hearts Day, donate to ShareHouse. Well, any day, donate to ShareHouse.
I did some research, and nonprofits will take money or accept donations every day.
I think so.
Every day.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
Sunday afternoon. Give me
Sunday
a call.
Sunday afternoon.
We'll have coffee.
But try on Giving Hearts Day and you won't get a truck.
Yeah. Well, and this year we have another great year with Valley Imports is doing a $10,000 match for us.
Oh,
so
wow.
Just that great part about Giving Hearts Day, your donations are doubled.
It's coming together. So. Mm-hmm. And so, no, that's great. So yeah, give on Giving Hearts Day. Thanks for taking some time out. And yeah, have a good week, everyone.
Thanks.
Were the cameras rolling the whole time? Holy crap! That's going to be a good soundbite at the end as well.